Once again, Gordo, the responsible one, gets left behind.
Thanks. Your support means the world to me.
Lizzie and Miranda get to go out and track down Matt and Lanny.
That it would be real helpful to ask the guy who knows about films to figure out where they shoot the video.
While I'm here by myself.
I'm just resting my eyes.
All alone.
I'm not sleeping. I was just resting my eyes.
With cable.
You didn't come over here to watch TV on the couch.
Fine, I'll watch TV in your room.
And video games. And a refrigerator full of food.
Ms. McGuire, have we ever turned down a free meal?
Maybe we're supposed to eat the rice pudding.
Alright, enough. French fries, give me French fries.
Did you say that I have an assistant that feeds me curly fries?
I'm hungry. Yeah, Lizzie's mom's a great cook. Way better than my mom. Why do you think I spend so much time at your house?
No, but it's tasty.
I'm not helping you. You just said to meet you here. You said you were gonna give me a hamburger. Repeat after me. Would you like fries with that? The Sinatra songs were all called Leave Me Alone. People used to wear, I couldn't care less. You can change your hair and you can change your clothes. You can change your mind. That's just... Their favorite food was goodbye.
Lord of the Flies is about shipwrecked children eating each other. I think I will order a pizza.
Cake.
I think we're ready for phase two.
Will phase two involve cookies?
I don't know. I'm just here for the free food. Because I like rice pudding.
Please, I think about food constantly.
For a smart guy, I can be kind of dumb sometimes.
You know, for a smart guy, you're wrong. It's like 90% of the time.
Brilliant observation, Gordo. How can you say that, Gordo?
Not helping, Gordo.
How can you say that, Gordo?
Oh, you're not helping.
I don't think so, Gordo.
Gordo, you've done it again.
I hate being right all the time. Whose side do you want me to be on here, yours or yours?
For a smart guy, you sure get a lot of stuff wrong.
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
Not helping, Gordo.
Say, you guys like jokes?
I got a great one.
Okay, so, King of Norway, he goes out into the woods with his number one hunter, right? So, did you hear the one about the King of Norway?
It's mine.
So, the King of Norway says, I thought he said he was a moose.
That was terrible.
I hope he didn't tell the King of Norway joke.
Yeah, I guess it was. Maybe that's because I told it wrong. Let me start again. How does it go? Okay. So the King of Norway, he goes out into the woods with his number one hunter.
Hey, Pally, Charlie, how's your bird?
Yo, Lizzie!
My great-grandfather was from a wee village in the Mull of Kintyre. I'm 1/8 Scottish, and I'm going with it. Shrimp. Good show.
Look at all the shrimp posters.
Oh, that's good shrimp toast. You guys gonna have some shrimp toast? I'm gonna have some more shrimp toast.
Do me a solid, doll. Take this double salt buck and grab me a platter I got on tap.
Good afternoon. My fiance and her friend are parking the car outside, and I was picking up the tickets for them. I'm just gonna break me off a piece of that and make every fair lassie trouble with a passion over for me.
Of course, old boy. Do help yourself. Mm. Good show, old chap. How can you go easy with a romping cat like Frank? You gotta hear him swing, baby.
No matter. I'll just break away from the Church of Rome, start the Church of England, have your head lopped off, and marry that saucy wench.
Okay.
My cousin had a hamster named Joey.
Yeah, well, you take the high road, I'll take the low road. But I'll be in math class before you.
I think we can rule out trampled to death by elephants.
Let's start the action.
Vamos, 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 para el oro!
And I'm ever so proud. I'll be feasting in merriment in Castle Gordon tonight.
Excuse me, ma'am. I'm with present security detail. Please clear the area.
Carry on, but do try harder. There's a good girl.
Cuckoo thread, sugar lips. Hey, Smokey, how's your bell and howl?
Yesterday? I learned how to tie my shoes? Nah, I forgot.
Ugh, the feast begins. We fill our gabs with the honest food of Scotland.
I shouldn't think that dirk is in the vocabulary of young Penelope. You might want to brush up on that.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Ciao. I am Aldo. Come on and ride with me on my Vespa. We'll eat gelati in the moonlight.
Dollface, you make me feel like spring has sprung.
Look at the noise I can make.
You want I should take care of a chimp? To you, I'm a zookeeper.
It'll be a mitzvah.
Spot of fresh air, eh? I suppose that's all very well, but it does keep one from tip-top sleuthing, what?
Hey, Charlie Bones, hitting the gasoline pretty good there, ain't ya?
I should live so long.
Why are you so obsessed with this float, Lizzie McGuire? Why?
I tell you, boy, do I need this day off.
Vamanos, 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 para el oro!
Fun's what it's all about, baby.
Yo, my name is P. Diddy. How are you ladies doing this fine day?
Like garbage this smells.
Feh. Sanitation engineer? I'm a garbage man. I'm Gordo the garbage man. My wife's a lawyer. I pick up trash.
I'm not gonna let this trash man thing get me down. I've got plans. Big plans. I'm gonna build a trash empire with employees and trucks and city contracts. It's gonna be huge. The key is one truck. Just one garbage truck. Then that becomes two garbage trucks. Then three. Then a lot of garbage trucks. A fleet of garbage trucks. For you see, trucks equal contracts, and contracts equal money, and money equals power.
Garbage is gold. Stinky gold, but gold nonetheless.
It's Tudgman.
Tudgman?
Okay, he's cracked.
Yeah, funny Tudgman.
That guy's got it made. Brains, brawn, babes.
I would not want to be Tudgman.
You lock lips with Larry Tudgman?
I'll help you get Cinderfella to the ball.
Tudgman.
Tudgman! He is my neighbor's brother's best friend.
The women in Eastern Africa would find you disturbingly pale and bizarrely dressed.
That's how the women here find them.
Great choice. Claire or Tudgman? Right, because nothing says Merry Christmas like a fiery spaceship crash.
Tudgman kicked your butt at the Science Olympics and at the Fact Athlon last year, which means we will be kicking your butt.
I hate that guy.
Tudgman, you've got a lot of work to do.
Am I a complete germ? Scale of 1 to 10. Scale of 1 to 10. What's my germ rating?
7.
Better than I expected. At the risk of sounding petty, go on.
If you ask me.
Not gonna. If you want my opinion.
Nope, I just want Teresa's.
Well, you're getting both.
Okay. I wasn't gonna say anything, but I think you need to hear this.
That's how everybody talks. I'm not everybody.
No more long lectures about how we care too much about what other people think about us.
The fact that you care so much about sitting with Ethan is kind of pathetic. So he's popular, and maybe he's good looking. So what? Who you are is way more important than who you sit with at lunch.
Look, in life you have two choices. One, you get to be super cool and popular for a few insignificant years of school. Or two, you get to become a valuable member of society and gloat about it at every reunion for decades afterwards. You can't have both.
Where do you get this stuff?
No more useless information about stuff we never even cared about in the first place.
Did you know that there was cannibalism in Trinidad and Tobago until 1850? There were a lot of pirates in that area too. They like to drag their prisoners under their ship across the razor-sharp coral reefs. On the other hand, they invented barbecue food.
Are you hungry?
I'm hungry. Did you know that motion pictures weren't really invented by Edison, like everybody thinks? They were invented by William Fries Green. But he was poor, so he sold the patent to Edison. Edison was almost completely deaf. He had eyebrows, like out to here.
Fine, Gordo. What'd you need to tell me about the mummy?
That I liked it?
Is that all?
And that when they made mummies, they used to pull their organs out through their nose.
No more packs of cupcakes to share.
No more cupcakes. Wait, why not?
Sorry I'm late. I was getting you guys some donuts.
Where are they?
Oh, I ate them. Yours said coconut. I know you don't like coconut. I brought you mini donuts.
Because they come in packs of threes. There's only two of us now.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should say Miranda. But he hurts you, Miranda. And how are you this fine afternoon, Miss Sanchez?
I'm gonna be Mrs. Matt McGuire.
Hey, Monica and Rachel.
Lizzie McGuire, I'm so disappointed
Gordo,
in you.
Gordo, give me a break.
It was my fault that Lizzie McGuire handed in my project.
Which is why I nominate you, Lizzie McGuire.
Morning, superstar.
Elizabeth. Now, what does that mean to you, Lizzie McGuire?
Lizzie McGuire.
Hey, McGee.
Lizzie McGuire.
Madge, the cosmetologist over there.
All right, Gordo, it's clear that...
Gordo. Gordo's the big girl from ESL.
Can't run out of my grill, dog.
Yo, Gordon.
Hey, Kraft.
David.
Maybe next time, little man.
These rules only apply to people like Gordork and Lizzie.
Remember, Gordon.
Dirk?
Glimmerfo, join us.
This is Gordo's house.
Gordo, the trash king. Your middle name is Zephyr. What's that about?
And she calls me David.
Hello, that's your name?
Hello. What do you call me?
Gordo!
Gordo. Gordo.
Gordo?
Do my parents think I'm so good that I can never get into trouble?
Yes.
I can make trouble. I have a dark side. I can disrespect the common areas. I can act without regard for the safety of others. Oh, I'm so sorry. Sorry, yet bad. 'Cause I'm bad.
Yeah, Gordo.
You're bad.
That was Gordo, obsessing about his hacky sack.
I was playing hacky sack just outside the neighbor's gate. My mother yelled, "It's getting late, dinner's ready, it won't wait." So I tried to negotiate and see if I could change my fate. Then I threw up my hacky sack, it rolled down the sewer grate. I looked in the sewer grate to see if I could extricate the hacky sack when my friend Nate came walking through the neighbor's gate. I was playing by the gate, my mom yelled out, "It's getting..."
You're a better dancer than Gordo anyway.
Enough without having to sing about it. Miranda?
Ding, ding dong, dong,
the witch is dead.
Which old witch?
The wicked witch.
When the weight of the world is on your trunk, show the world that you've got spunk. Say what you think, say you like pink, stand up for what you believe.
Ding dong, the wicked witch is dead.
Oh, sorry, that's all I know anyway. I'll get you the rest of the lyrics off the internet.
We get it, Gordo. She's stacked.
Yes, yes she is. Well, you may not have her talent, and you may not have her charm. She does have that great smile.
Can you guys believe Kate?
Ooh. Holy ravioli.
I don't think you'll be my photographer, Gordo. I don't plan on doing any lingerie fashion shows or swimsuit competitions.
Forget it then.
Oh, I probably should warn you. If you think you don't like your body now, just wait.
Here's the part that gets me all confused. Not that Gordo has a girlfriend, but that Gordo is somebody's boyfriend.
Ew.
I know. Very hard to imagine.
Thank you.
long enough, anything can happen.
A bookstore containing the works of Navajo and Greek philosophers, a coffee house where people only discuss music and politics, a 1,000-foot water slide ending in a swim-up counter where they serve free deep-fried pizza, and Tyra Banks would be the mayor. I've given this a lot of thought.
Cool, but when you start talking about shopping for school supplies, let me know when you mean school supplies or, school supplies.
Deal.
5:30? You rise. You shine.
His parents tell me he's really cranky in the mornings.
I love the mornings. This is the middle of the night. You get up. You get dressed.
Gordo's cranky in the morning.
I'm not cranky. I'm
just gonna be a blackjack dealer. You only have to count to 21.
Okay, Gordo. Imagine you live in a boring suburb where all the houses look alike and everybody's predictable.
I do live in a boring suburb where all the houses look alike and everyone's predictable. Thank you.
Whatever it is making me all tingly inside. Do you guys feel a blast of Arctic wind from Sweden, where they hand out the Nobel Prize?
I need something to make all the girls like me.
Oh, yeah. It's working already. I feel a bit, faint.
Think of him as Marilyn Manson to your Britney Spears. I'm gonna go and flip the circuit breakers so we can play some loud music. Real music. 6 hours? 6 hours? Let me guess, that's how tall Tom Cruise is.
Neurology? Neurology, how about cosmetology?
You guys will never believe what I got on tape.
Elvis? Bigfoot?
Close. Kate. Kate, I'm not your partner. I've never been your partner. I will never be your partner. There is nothing on this earth that can convince me to be your partner. All right, you talked me into it.
What's your email, Lizzie? Lizzie@biggiantloser.com.
Could you say that one more time for the camera, Kate? I'm trying to cast the part of the bitter, talentless girl.
For once, I'd just like Kate to say thank you and mean it.
Gordo?
Yeah?
You're sitting on my sweater.
Oh. So, Kate, besides an F in science, what else do you expect to find in the woods today?
Why would you guys want to help me? Because everybody needs a friend, Kate. And you obviously don't have any.
And we don't want to be them, so we gotta get your old ones back.
Not only do I not walk you to class, but I don't speak to you, because I don't like you. You're a stuck-up snob who thinks that because she's a cheerleader, she's better than everyone else.
I like two Lizzies, but two Kates? That's scary.
Ethan Kraft draws back his flat stick and rolls his rock.
Well, there's a rock-solid foundation. We'll go from there.
It's online, but what's this?
I don't want to disappoint him.
King Tut's mummy has suddenly come alive and is stalking the gallery, tearing the heads off of innocent spectators.
Grunt and a locker slam. That can only mean one thing. Somebody's got a book report?
And now the Mir space station is falling out of the sky.
Bowling is fun. Bowling is good. Bowling will not make my fingers swell.
Good boy!
Oh, the humanity!
Bowling is fun. Bowling is good. Bowling will not make my fingers swell.
Mercy, a piece of debris is heading right at me, and
I don't want to be the ball.
I'm gonna go get me some nachos.
Oh, being the pins isn't working either.
I'm gonna have to take a sabbatical.
Everyone's prepared off. It's like Noah's Ark, with fluorescent lighting.
I've been the ball, I've been the pins. There's no way I'm gonna be the shoes.
Maybe if you got me a cup of fresh squeezed coffee.
I can't believe you're gonna break Matt's heart.
You know what? You just want to keep this going for your own sick amusement.
Well, yeah. Yodelay-hee, yodelay-hee, yodelay-hee-hoo.
That was so worth it.
Glad I didn't have to tell you.
Pudding cup sealed, untouched by cafeteria lady hand.
What do I say to that?
I say you go out with them. The shirts are pretty cool.
Wait a minute. I had to say yodelay-hee-hoo.
That was your code phrase? That's bogus.
Yep, nothing says cool like getting arrested, especially at school.
Hello?
Oh, like when Lizzie was in the fourth grade, she had a crush on you.
Yeah, I guess it's not the best example.
You did?
She did?
I broke my toe. But I lived.
What? I did. It was my big toe. I had to go to the hospital. It was very traumatic.
And in honor of Hanukkah, I made potato pancakes.
Oh, thanks.
What?
At least something more than happened to me.
Can't get away from those. Every December, it's all I eat. Well, the good news is you'll be exploring the wonderful world of Latvia.
All of them. NASCAR, Formula One, Formula Two, nitro-powered funny cars.
I hate Lizzie. Great. Use the untapped powers of the universe to land a guy who's gonna end up working at a gas station. Part-time. You've got fake penguins. Who doesn't love penguins? Oh, you aren't kidding.
Oh, please, can we?
But what if I spill something on them?
Oh, my heart!
Sad thing is, I understood that.
I swear on the sacred shield of Olwen Thunder Eater, it has not.
Greasy Review by Lizzie McGuire. Scranton. Well, that really says it all. I probably would have gone with Pittsburgh, but you know me. I overstate things.
Hey, I could write a dictionary that translates English into girlish. I could make millions. Yeah, there's this talking dog flick out that I really want to catch. It seems as Master has been spending too much time at the office neglecting the wife and the kids, and the talking dog shows him the error of his ways.
That hurts.
How do you women feel about the word fembonics?
You mean the authentic 1986 Super Bowl football signed by Walter Payton?
No, Gordo, the other one.
You have two?
You've been into your dad's shrink files again, haven't you?
His Tuesday at 3:30 is really scary.
Come on, Lizzie, show us. Ow!
Good luck with that saving the earth thing, guys. I gotta go drop eggs off the roof.
Oh! How would you do that?
I was just getting in touch with my hunter warrior instincts.
Gordo! Gordo, what are you doing?
Survival of the fittest?
Gordo!
I heard a little snoring coming from your room last night.
Okay, sushi, wasabi, sinuses, snoring, yeah, okay, I got it, Grandma.
It was Ethan's idea. Yeah, Ethan, I just made a $35 million action movie and they're showing it at the assembly.
Hey, way to go, Gordo, I'll be there.
But the important thing is, I have a topic for my documentary, The Making of a Champion. I wonder if Spielberg started this way.
Yeah, well, how about the fact that he's already made a movie? A movie, and not just any movie, but a feature film with Steven Spielberg. And he's younger than I am. He's younger than me.
You're not doing a film about the life cycle of the running shoe again, are you?
Spielberg.
Well, I've been singing Oops, I Did It Again into a hairbrush. People have been going to the Olympics and playing for the governor and Spielberging.
How long have you known me, Lizzie?
Almost my whole life.
And in that time, how long have I wanted to make movies?
Well, forever.
Spielberging? Did Gordo do another movie? Because I love that one he did about the running shoes. He is so talented.
Can't believe it. My debut as a director, and here I am not wearing a baseball hat.
Exactly. She may never be a professional musician.
No, you're supposed to say I may never be a professional director.
Are we here to talk crazy, or are we here to help Lizzie?
Take 22, Mark. And action.
What you got to say?
Now let's go again. Cut. The line's right.
Mark.
I'm killing me. Cut, cut, cut. Ethan. What are you doing?
Okay, we're out of film.
This is a disaster.
I mean, Gordo, you're smart.
Great. A pop quiz. I love the smell of pop quizzes in the morning.
I've been given the opportunity to skip ahead. Go to high school?
I got an A.
Suddenly, it all makes sense. No one could be that smart in junior high.
Oh, an A. I'm ever so proud.
Wow, Gordo. You're like one giant brain. Except you have legs. So you're not in a jar.
Right.
And you're funny.
I didn't know you had a look, Gordo.
Maybe I should get a look. How about this?
Excuse me, ma'am. I'm with present security detail. Please clear the area.
I don't think so, Gordo.
How about these? Ciao, I am Aldo. Come on and ride with me on my Vespa. We will eat gelati in the moonlight.
Keep trying, Gordo.
Yo, my name is P. Diddy. How are you ladies doing this fine day?
You know what? I'm just gonna go over there and check the lipsticks. Yeah.
A little weird sometimes,
I may not even have my picture taken. I'm gonna tell my teacher I grew up with the Kalahari Desert Bushmen, and I believe if someone takes my picture, they'll steal my soul away from me, and I'll be doomed to eternal wandering.
You're weird.
But I wouldn't like you any other way.
Gordo, you made it. And no cowboy boots.
Yeah, they weren't exactly me.
Good choice.
Oh, Gordo's back!
Yeah.
Well, we're lucky enough to have a hardcore nonconformist who totally doesn't care what anybody thinks about what he likes.
I don't want to start panicking or anything, but what's the deal with Miranda?
Okay, well, I think that she...
She's obviously not herself, you know, with the whole diet thing. I mean, you were there. She nearly fainted rehearsing for my video. I don't know, maybe I should shelve the project.
Gordo, I think you really...
Or maybe you should talk to her. I know that the three of us are best friends, but it's just that you two have that girl thing.
Well, you know...
Look, I know that magazines these days are telling girls that they have to be thinner. They're telling me I have to be more muscular, and for whatever the reason, Miranda's buying into it, and I'm not. Not saying that you are, of course. It's just I think you have a better handle on this situation than I would, which is why I think you should talk to her.
Gordo, wait!
What?
Okay. I want to talk to her just as bad as you do, okay? In fact, we're going to the mall tomorrow. I'll talk to her then.
Well, that's great, because I think she needs to know that we're her friends, that if she ever needs anyone to talk to, that we're her go-to peeps. Through thick, through thin, we'll always be there. And I gotta tell you that the whole idea of you talking to her is a huge relief, because frankly, I'd have no idea what to say. And you never figure out who you really are if you're busy trying to be someone else. Parents scrape and sacrifice to provide us with shelter, support, and guidance. And in return, we have as little to do with them as possible. It's nature's law. As little communication as possible. It prepares us for marriage. Why do you have to be so cooperative? Why can't you be bitter and cynical like a normal student? You know what? I don't think she cares what they think. And I think that's pretty cool. This doesn't leave the table. For a second, it bothered me. Frankly, our classmates should get lives. They're worrying about what I like and what I do. I never knew I was so important. Thank you all for coming to my bar mitzvah. Today is important for a lot of different reasons, but mostly because today I leave my childhood behind, become a man. Now, the truth is, I could have marked this transition a million different ways. And believe me, I considered most of them. But I knew that whatever I did, it had to be right for me. So I searched and I questioned, and I heard lots of stories from many men. Funny thing is, the person I learned most about was me. And I realized that figuring out who I am was made easier by realizing who I'm not. So why this bar mitzvah and not a tattoo? Or fishing? Or even a dirt bike? The answer is simple. It's because this is what felt right to me. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher bachar banu mikol ha'amim. V'natan lanu et torato, Baruch atah Adonai, noten ha-torah.